Warning.
Some of the tips you're about to see will be super helpful, some will be moderately helpful, and some will be slightly helpful, but I promise none of them are counterproductive, okay? Also, every bug was harmed in the making of this video. You all thought you had to wait till July 3rd before Nintendo added some extra oomph to Animal Crossing New Horizons, but stop! Hold on. It's Saturday, June 27th, and today is the first ever bug off, and Nintendo is bringing a little bit of fancy fun before we get to summer update number one. What's going on, everybody? It's Zach from Bug Off, and we're back with some epic bug tips because today Flick enters the town, and we're ready to take our talents to his competition. If you guys are excited for the Bug Off and excited for that July update, smash that like button. Let me know in the comments down below what part of the update you want most, and if you are a true bug boy or bug girl, because today is all about the bugs, and everybody's been sharing their tips. They've been talking about how to get 300 points for the gold trophy. Listen, I got the best tips this side of YouTube, and I'm gonna tell you exactly how to do this thing the right way. Now, everybody's been talking about one big tip, and I think it's a pretty obvious tip. I think it's a pretty in your brain space tip that you probably already know, but I'll give it to you since every other channel is giving it to you. Bring a net. Oh my goodness, get your best net and bring it to the bug off, because how the heck else are you gonna catch the freaking bugs without a net? It is important to have a net, I guess. A gold net would do you well, but any net will work a-okay, and they might break, but just get a new one. Yes, have a net. But most importantly, Flick, he's hanging out here. He's ready to go. He's got prizes for you. You can play this, you know, by yourself. You can play with other people. You can work to achieve that 300-point total and get some pretty cool items. It functions very similarly to CJ's fishing tournament, which I did like and have fun with. And the bug off's a little bit more random, in my opinion, because the bugs are kind of just all over the place, and you can't just go to a specific spot, and there's no bait. Eventually, maybe we'll get honey, which I think is a super califragilistic idea. Right now, though, you just kind of have to hunt for bugs. But my extra good tip for you today is to stump it up. Absolutely chop the heck out of your trees. That may sound counterintuitive, it may sound very unproductive, it may make your island look very barren, but I promise you, it will bring out the best bugs in the land. Having so many stumps is such a good way to set up a bug-catching fiasco. And I'm serious, stump it up is a seriously great tip, because what do bugs like most of all? Somewhere to sit and something to sniff. That's why flower patches and a bunch of destroyed oxygen givers is your best bet to increase your bug mother load. This is gonna supersize your score legitimately, as long as you're okay with replanting saplings. Look at how many creepy crawlies have appeared thanks to my bugaforming. It's an alternate form of terraforming that I made up myself, and it's working out really nicely. So chop and plant and put your score through the buggy roof. But do not stress, because guys and girls, even though this is the first ever bug off, it's for Northern Hemisphere players, you're gonna get another bug off every month for the next few months. There's July 25th, and then another one in August, and then September, so we're chilling like villains here in the Northern Hemisphere. Do not stress, okay? If you're in the Southern Hemisphere, maybe stress a little bit, because your first bug off isn't until November, which seems a little odd and far away, but if you're in the Northern Hemisphere, it's all good. Southern Hemisphere, you guys got the shark season way before us. You lucked out, you won out there. You're gonna have to take the L on this. You don't get the bug off for a long time. And frankly, you don't need to stress even if you don't have the bug off, or even if you do, because the items frankly aren't that great. This is what I collected, or at least a smorgasbord of some of the things I collected from the fishing tournament. Now, the fishing tournament itself is very fun, but this strange plaque of dead squid, this kind of ugly fishing shirt, this giant fishing cooler, the anchor, the fish wand, the little put it on your door plaque. I don't know. The pochette is kind of nice. It reminds me of Rainbow Fish, a book that my brother loved as a small child. But look, the wares aren't that wonderful. The good gets are going to be from Pascal and his wonderful underwater trading service that I'm very excited for. You got that mermaid gear, you got those new DIYs, and it is going to be very spicy and then completely cooled off by the water that you dive into as you somersault to swim. So a wonderful world of new items is coming our way soon. Don't stress about the bugs, but also, guys and girls, you do have to show respect to the bug off. And most people think you want a bug type outfit like this. You know, you got the cute bee sting. Oh gosh, I'm one with the bugs. Look, I got the binoculars and the little pants and the little outdoor boots. No, this is not how you do the bug off right. Tip number most important is, if you're gonna bug off the right way, if you're gonna really make sure that you bug your way to victory, you need to dress for the occasion. You need to put on your best bugs outfit and get ready. You want the bugs to feel comfortable. You want them to feel safe. You want them to know that you're sweet as honey since the game don't got any. And I'm putting on a buttermilk cotton pineapple shirt to really attract and waft those bugs in. I got the leaf mask to blend in. I got some nice kitty shoes that are neon, but also the color of maybe, you know, a certain beetle that we all love. And you gotta really, you gotta get in the mood. And Flick will say, gosh darn, I'm proud of you for dressing for the occasion. That's what we need to do. It's not okay to just dress like you're ready for a safari zone. You really want to be your best bug boy or bug girl self. And then to complement that, you really want to put on some good bug music. You need good bug hunting music, some tunes there to really power you to a perfect run and round. You get 1 point for one bug, 2 points for two bugs. Once you get three, four, or five bugs, you're gonna start really racking up the points, and you'll get those extra bonuses as you boost your score. And Flick will be happy, and this dude is a really sad guy. So after you have your music, and after you have your correct outfit, I think the next most important thing is to give Flick some love. Give him a hug, compliment him, high five. You know, Flick is stressed out. I feel like CJ, his life partner, is annoying the heck out of him back at their apartment. Flick doesn't get a permanent spot. He has to wander the island all hours of the day. CJ has to wander the island. They don't get permanent spots. They're jealous of Leaf. They're jealous of Red. It doesn't make sense why these guys don't get a more permanent home. Heck, Isabel won't even announce their faces as they arrive on the island. There are basically nothing to resident services, which feels completely unfair. So a hug, a high five, a compliment, maybe even a kiss on the cheek will go a long way to upping your bug score and hopefully your rapport with Flick, who previously has built you bug trophies, bought your bugs, but now he is ready to put your skills to the test with this amazing contest. And if you want the contest to really work out as we start to show you how this goes, you're going to need to bring some friends. And so I'm gonna show you exactly how that works, because friends can participate in the bug off together, and that will help you just really compound your score quickly if you're searching for these items. There are some good ones, okay? You don't want any spoilers, close your eyes, but look at this. Look at some of these. Okay, maybe a little bit of a stronger selection than the fish. Not quite a superstar collection, and I still believe that those mermaid items are gonna really, really make you a happy camper. Start the bug off, put my bug net, and okay, here we go, me and my friends. Oh wait, I don't have any, it's just me. Okay, let's hunt for bugs. Well, if I had friends, I'd bring them and we could do it together, but no friends. Marina, you wanna help me bug hunt? Flick, you got your net over there, dude. Can we move together in unison? I see a bug. Just me and my bugs hanging out, getting stuck on geometry, moving slow. There's a bug. I got it. If I had a friend, we could do it together. This is the price you pay for playing Lonely Co-op and sitting in your house all day making YouTube videos for 10 years and talking to Animal Crossing characters and getting sad about Snooty and happy about bug offs, but it's okay. Don't worry. One day we'll have friends and we'll be able to make it work. If you guys are looking for friends to bug off with, I do recommend our Switch Strong Discord server. It's a little late for that right now for me, so I'm sure they would happily join if it was any other hour. But this bug off could not wait. I had to get you guys the real deal info. So, like, look, bringing a net, mission critical. If you don't bring a net, what are you doing? You won't even be able to partake in the bug off. Stump it up, get these stumps. They're not yielding anything glorious right now, but I'm sure eventually these stumps will be loaded with disgusting, creepy, crawly creatures that we'll shove in our pockets and eventually soil our entire wardrobe. Make sure that you put on your best bug outfit. Make sure that you turn on some big bug music. And don't stress if you're a Northern Hemisphere player, because the items aren't that great, and you're gonna get another chance next month, and the month after that, and the month after that. Now, if you're Southern Hemisphere, whew, big stress, guys. November is your bug off. You can also time travel, but I know that's kind of taboo, so we won't talk about it too much. Look at this little guy, my third bug. Give me some points. I do want to grab that bug catching backpack. I think it's pretty good. If you want to really up your oomph, I think giving Flick a little bit of love, the saddest NPC in the game. You know, he's definitely not the scariest. That belongs to Red 100% of the time. But, you know, Flick seems bummed out. I mean, I don't know if it's because CJ and him aren't getting along. I don't know what's going on at the house day, Flick J. But, you know, I think it honestly has something to do with the disrespect that Isabel gives them at Resident Services. That Tom Nook told her, like, look, these guys aren't even worth announcing. Isabel, I appreciate you, like, really caring about this or whatever. But it's not that important. Don't even announce them. Five bugs by myself. Who needs friends? Friends, just slow it down, right? They arrive slowly on the Dodo flights. They take forever to get here. They goof up your game. They can cause your bulletin board art to disappear. I've had nightmares about that before. It's actually happened to me previously. Wasn't a pleasant sight. But I think this bug off is a nice diversion until July 3rd. As I mentioned, that is when the big update is coming. That is when swimming and diving are going to enter our face space, and we're going to be really happy to see, oh my gosh, how many new things enter our world. And then we get summer update number 2 in August. It's about to be a beautiful time to play Animal Crossing, starting with this Saturday showdown, me versus you in the bug off. Who can get 300 points? Maybe don't go all that way, because honestly, the trophy isn't that great. You got the plaques from the museum, International Museum Day, that you got over and over and over again. And if you want the trophy, I understand it's respectable, but at the end of the day, I do wish that Flick had some better prizes. He will buy my bugs, as CJ bought my fish haul, so I can dump these guys and not have them creeping and crawling around. But for my money, the best bugs are in the house, the cockroaches, but Flick doesn't count those for some reason. I don't know, he's got a personal feud with them that needs to be described in detail at a later date. So let's, can I get my prizes? Have I checked my bug cage? If you don't want your bugs, you can buy them. Buy them all. Buy all my bugs. Give me a prize. Let's see what the first prize we get after, 2,000 bells. Now you're gonna want some bells, because every entry after the first is a paid ticket. Flick is a good Samaritan for one run, and then if you're gonna work your way towards that 300, you gotta do it again. Now I am ready for my first prize, Flick. What are you going to give me? Make sure to hit that like button if you guys are excited for new stuff coming to AC. It's been so long, man. And now we finally have some goodies coming into our pockets, both literally and metaphorically. It works that way with Animal Crossing. So often things make sense. What does he say? Does he say I don't have enough points for him? Is that what he's trying to tell me? Flick, really? After I gave you a hug and told everyone to be nice to you? So far, your point total is 8. Once you save up, oh my goodness, hold on. All right, Flick, I doubled my score. We're ready for the prize. Give the people what they deserve. What are we gonna get? 16 points, dig into the reliquary, and I've redeemed it for a bug relic, a spider web. Oh my goodness gracious, I participate in your big contest that I waited freaking 3 months for, and that Southern Hemisphere players are gonna wait another 5 months for, and I get a spider web. As you can see, this is why I'm a little salty and jaded on the bug off, but at the end of the day, it is good, simple fun, and I like it a lot. I hope these tips have made your day a little bit better. At the end of the day, you don't really need tips. Everyone knows how to freaking get the bugs. But some things will help you out, like, stumping it up is important. I think wearing a really exciting outfit is important, and obviously bringing a friend if you have any will definitely help you reach that high score in a much quicker way. But if you don't, you got more chances. So everybody, thanks so much for being here and giving me a chance to brighten your day and fill it with bugs. I, again, appreciate all you so much. I hope you're staying safe and staying healthy out there. Special shout out to the members. I see you guys. Always with your little Joy-Con symbols commenting in the comments. So cute and cool. And let's make sure that we're ready for next week. So get your islands looking spiffy. We got new items, diving, swimming. I got you guys all covered as early as I possibly can with that big update. So make sure to subscribe, turn the notification bell on so you're ready for summer update number 1 and everything else we've got going, including my big 3-month Animal Crossing tribute. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. And until next time, everybody, thank you so much once again. Have a fantastic rest of your day. I love you a lot. SwitchForce, out.